presentation was about how we can learn from digital disasters and what we can learn from other industries, especially the boating industry, where we've had the Titanic. And my argument is that we live in a pre-Titanic era with regards to information security. We behave in very old-fashioned manners. We are not willing to share information, and we're not willing to apply the basic fundamentals to protect ourselves from digital disasters. Well, what we've learned from the Titanic is that we need a set of universal rules that we apply to every larger ship, so that we have less disasters when coming into a harbor, that we have traffic rules, that we come to one another's aid when needed, those type of basics. And what we see in the information technology is that we do not apply any basics, that rules are very bound per nation. And we live on the internet, which is basically a digital sea where somebody in one country can affect systems in another country. So having rules only on a local level only does so much. And what we need to learn, just as we learned when using boats, is that we need to apply the same rules to everybody and the same basic measures to at least ensure a certain level of safety. And of course you can go even further and add things to that, but the basic premise is that we try to learn and apply the basics. And if you look at the big security incidents, like the recent viruses outbreaks, like non-Petya or Petya and WannaCry, that we didn't update our systems properly enough. That's typically one of those basics. Have a life vest, have a rescue boat. And those parallels really do apply to information security. Now, in my research that I'm doing, I'm trying to find out what are the life vests that we really need in every organization to at least submerge from a disaster, or preventing a disaster from happening, or reducing the risks. So stop thinking about safe or not safe, but let's start thinking about risk management, what security at the end of the day really is. If you look at digital disasters when they occur, we learn that the first thing we do is lock everything down. Let not other people learn from the mistakes we've made. So you see an underworld of criminals exchanging very important security information, and the victims trying to keep silent about it. It's like many types of crime that you see, that as long as you have a taboo around it, it's very hard to deal with it. Meanwhile, the criminals are exchanging the information, so how to abuse a system is widely known, but everybody knows but the victim. And if we would start to share a little bit of that information, or dare to cry for help and dare to have the rule that we should help one another at the moment when things go awry, that would change the world significantly.